Welcome back, kids. This is the A-Side. I'm your host, Riley. And today I'm going to be reacting to the second half of CHVRCHES, The Bones of What You Believe. And I'm so excited because I loved every minute of the first half of the record. I mean, every minute of it, every second of it. It was pretty much the perfect pop album for me. I loved every minute of it. It's everything I think synthwave should be. Lord Mayberry is an amazing vocalist, a cool lyricist. The synths were just so warm. The melodies were interesting. The layering and the mixing and the engineering and all of it was so good. Everything was just amazing. And now I'm really excited to be reacting to part two. And also, after reviewing the first half of the video, I realized I was mixed a little too low here in the mix of the audio. I realized my mistake. Hopefully it's better now. I turned it up a bit. It's my first time using OBS. This is only the second ever video of me doing one of these videos using OBS. So if the music is outpowering me or if I'm too loud, please let me know. And while you're down there, go ahead and hit subscribe if you're new around here. It's free. And you can always unsubscribe if you want. We're on the road to 200, boys. Let's do it. And leave a like if you want to see me react to the second CHVRCHES album. Just whatever else you want. I don't know. I'll get around to it eventually. Let's just do this. Let's hop right into it. With track 7, entitled Recover. Let's hope it has nothing to do with Eminem. Cut. Once again, we're just sounding amazing all the way through. Every bit of this just sounds amazing. Very 80s sounding synthesizers. These remind me a lot of The Cure. This inspiration. A lot more so Kiss Me, Kiss Me, Kiss Me, because it's much warmer, but it reminds me of that kind of late 80s era Cure, and I love it. It's so cool. I would say this is probably the weakest song thus far, but it's still really good. The chorus works really well, though. I find a lot of these choruses have these like cool little lines like, I'll be the thorn in the side until you die. I'll be your comfort if you recover. And all these little lyrics throughout the record I've been picking up on, I think they're all really cool. And it proves, I think, that Lauren Mayberry is a very talented lyricist, along with being an amazing vocalist. I talk about her a lot, but she's just so great. This band has, I've become a very, this band has won me over as a fan of new videos. Very cool. Another great song on this record, honestly. I don't have too much to say, other than that the synths sounded warm and comforting, and Lauren Mayberry's vocals were beautiful, and her lyrics were great. It has those little sharp dagger lines in the chorus that I've noticed throughout a lot of this record. I say dagger, and they're not necessarily, like, mean or, like, venomous like a dagger. They're not necessarily, more so that they're very sharply written and very witful. Very much the sharpest tool in the shed when it comes to Lauren here, at least in these little short phrases of lyrics that just really hit you like, wow. So yeah, Recover gets that green. It had nothing to do with Eminem. That's a big thumbs up. I know there are very few Eminem fans that also listen to CHVRCHES, so I think I'm safe. But track 8, Night Sky. I I like the like percussion here. It sounds cool. How it's doing different stuff. Almost sounds like a wood block, maybe. Like a more synthetic version of a wood block. I don't know how many of you are familiar with like different instruments and stuff, like the wood block. Maybe there's a more scientific name for it. I don't know. I think it's just called it. Cool guitars. I'm the night sky, I'm the fire in your eyes. I don't know. That's a really cool way of describing like a relationship. What a good lyricist. The lyrics on this are so good. That was cool. Background vocals are great. I love that being there. And it gives it a cool dynamic between a guy and a girl kind of singing about a relationship. The guy kind of in the background fading out. That's a cool touch. Whether they did that purposely or not, or were they just like, hey, dude, in the band, sing backup. Either way, it sounds really good. I'm such a good curlo. A dreamy little breakdown again. I'm all about this. Oh, the drums there, mate. That was great, mate. I love that. Night sky. Green folder. That was really good. Just another great song. Like I said, I don't really have much more to say besides it's just so cool. There are a lot of like little cool pieces of that song too that kind of were in the other things. Some of the percussion there at the end was really great. Some of the drums when they really came in. The background vocals were kind of a cool touch. The way it's like kind of a relationship song, and it has the guy and the girl singing the same lyrics, so they kind of feel the same, but then the background singer, the guy, is kind of fading out, kind of symbolizing that things are kind of ending. Whether that was on purpose or not, it's still really cool. So yeah, great stuff so far. Science/Visions, of course, it's not the greatest song of all time, Tell the Vision off of Kanye West Donda, but close enough name. That's a joke, by the way, that sound blows. Let's continue. Science and Visions, or slash Visions. Let's do this, boys and girls. Ooh, we're getting a little more dancey on this one. I'm here for it. The title Science/Visions is interesting because science, you know, based on logic and fact and stuff, and then real and visions. In real world, and visions is more ideas of spiritualism, more mystical. So that's a cool kind of juxtaposition just within the title itself. How science/visions, when those things definitely aren't something to be slashed, you know, they're very much two very different things, coming from two very different realms of thought and idea, both the pragmatic and mystical. Sounds really cool though. Lord's vocals in the beginning sounded very desperate and sad. And now this like weird breakdown, the vocals almost sound a little off tune in spots with the synth line, creating kind of that unsettling a little bit feeling about things when we aren't. Those synths sound amazing. This is like the exact synth tone I love for the entire record. The entirety of this record is easily like what my ideal synth tone sounds like. That's so cool, the drum hit. Banger alert! That song was great. The synth tone is like, I mean, throughout the entire album it's been like this, but especially here, it's just like how I love to hear my synthesizers. The exact kind of tone and sound I adore. And this song had everything. It had intensity and drama. Just the entire vibe of it felt kind of despondent in a way. A lot more so than some of the other tracks on this record. So interesting. Interesting vibes. I'm gonna give it the green. Like I said, I don't have much to say besides the fact that it's just really great. Some of the best, probably the best synth pop I've heard since the 80s. Wow. Track 10, long. This is a short one. It's probably the shortest song on the record thus far. How long till you leave it? You should know that. That's cool. Okay, very, very briefly, right? That started off very strange, with these really loud "woo" sounds. I didn't like it. But then it comes in, and it has like some of the most like bubblegummy pop melodies ever, and I love that kind of stuff. On this time, keep yourself a secret. You should know that I will sell you a future you don't want like it did last time. The melodies are sugary, sugary sweet. I love it. That's a bit heavier and more distorted here. It's different from the rest of the album. Keep me in your eyeline, keep but the melody is just beautiful. Before. Oh my god. I will change direction. I will tell you that everything's moving too slowly. Just another lie. One more time. This is wonderful. absolutely wonderful. Lungs. It was a bit different, a bit more distorted, a bit kind of rough around the edges in some of their tracks. I'm not gonna say it's hyperpop, but maybe a little proto hyperpop with kind of how loud some things were here. But I loved it, especially with the mix of kind of the loudness at the beginning and at certain parts of the song. And then the super, super sugary, sweet melody is like as sweet as you can get here, as poppy, bubblegum melody as you can get. But I love that kind of stuff. And it was pulled off so well here. Everything about the song I loved. The Green. Come on. This album's so good. There are two tracks left. And honestly, I don't even know what to say besides the fact that it's just... wow. The entire time. It's just been so good. And, yeah, let's just continue. Penultimate track by The Throat. It's a joke. Make a wish. Just to kind of create a little more drama, a little more suspense. What's it gonna do? What's the drop gonna be? Ooh. And it's beautiful! I love all the different electronic sounds. It's just like a wave of stuff between all the electronics, the drums, Lauren's vocals, and the background vocals. It's just so much that just kind of a moment of like, wow. Ooh, spacey sounding synths there, that's cool. This is really great stuff. I like how they just keep adding random synth sounds and stuff, and how it just keeps building on more and more. It just keeps things so interesting. You don't get bored of a song because more shit's being thrown at you. And it's all working, too. It's not like you're just throwing stuff on the wall and seeing what sticks. What was thrown at the wall stuck so hard that it can't get off 20 years later, you know? That's an awful analogy, but I'm trying to say that this stuff is really good. By the Throat. That's great. It was about, like, I don't know, a fight. That's what it sounded like. Whether a physical one or one of words or even a struggle emotionally. I just thought it was beautiful the whole way through, especially when the beat drops and all the stuff comes in. And it's just a big moment of kind of everything shining. The background vocals and Lauren both shining, along with all the different synth sounds and the drums. All just shine at once in a beautiful moment. The entire song is beautiful. The entire record is beautiful. This is such a good record, honestly. And sad to say, we're now at the final track, You Caught the Light. Okay, fading in very slowly. Drama for the rest of the ooh. Just sounds very futuristic, very heavenly, almost. Like you're just looking out at some beautiful otherworldly plane. Or the light shining on you. Oh! That's really cool! The bass here sounds amazing too. It's just so pretty. This song is just making me, getting in the feels with just instruments. But it's interesting because you can get it. And once I understood that the sound, you know, at the beginning was the light coming and being shown upon somebody. And it's that moment you see them and they caught the light and you're just so in love, and you get all that feeling when you just see someone, and even in a crowd of people or in a dark room, the light just seems like it's just right on them. It's all you're focusing on, and that's just kind of what it sounds like. Those like warm emotions of like love and affection is what this song sounds like. That's awesome. When you can convey something like that strictly through instrumentation, you're extremely talented and deserve all the praise. I mean, bands like American Football, and CHVRCHES. So, yeah. Sing again, and that's just so nice. I like that. And it's his vocals with the reverb on it. You're so dreamy. Oh, those synths are so like loud and overpowering. And the harsh vocals, and then the background of the bass line, all of that together, it just sounds so dreamy and beautiful. This might be the best song on the record. For the long closing track. Wow. That was amazing. That was so dreamy and overwhelming and just beautiful. The way the vocals were so hushed and the bass line really was just so great. And then on top of that, the synths were just so loud and overpowering, but not in a way of, oh my god, it's mixed badly, in the way that it just makes this dreamy noise and vibe to it. Beautiful. Absolutely beautiful closing track. Maybe even the best song on the album. That gets the green. And with that, we finished CHVRCHES's debut album, The Bones of What You Believe. I believe it's their debut album. Let's take a look. Okay. It is their debut album. So yeah. What an amazing debut. Honestly, for The Bones of What You Believe, after my first listen, first reaction, of course, the score isn't permanent. But I am feeling on The Bones of What You Believe a 10. A 10 out of 10. This is everything I would ever want from a synth pop album. It was so amazing, all of it. I enjoyed every minute of this song. Apparently there are bonus tracks, it looks like. I'm not going to listen to those now, but maybe some other time I will. Anyway, wow. What an amazing record, guys, huh? Yeah. So, what do you guys think of this album? Should I listen to the next, should I listen to the next record? What do you think? I probably will. If you want me to, leave a like on this video and subscribe. Stick around. I'll do it sooner than later. Yeah. Thank you for watching, truly. And I'll see you all next time.